Bonus content video number 4. Blood sugar. This is a teaspoon. That's about 5 to 8 grams. That's not very big. This is how much your body can absolutely, in a lovely way, regulate blood sugar. Because you see, in the wild, you'd only have about a handful of plant-source foods that you gathered. Fruits and berries in the wild are very bitter. So even if you gathered a handful of berries, you would still have about 5 to 8 grams, or a little bit over. That's not a lot of carbohydrate. And that requires less insulin. Insulin is a storage hormone. And so when you're eating like sandwiches and oatmeal and quinoa, which you think is healthy, and the brown rice and, you know, the juice and the juice fast and all this kind of stuff and the juicing, you're raising your blood sugar exponentially past that 1 teaspoon. That means that your pancreas has to work. Can I speak English? I don't know. It has to work too hard. It's constantly trying to bring that blood sugar back down because blood sugar is toxic to the bloodstream. It kills cells. It pumps up and around and up and around, and it goes down and it can create neuropathy and arthritis and, I mean, you name it, fibroids, endometriosis, low testosterone, cancer, like all autoimmune disorders from eating high-level diabetes, I mentioned that, especially type 2, from having elevated levels of glucose. And that glucose now, because the insulin is constantly from the pancreas over-secreted, it has a hard time to actually work, get the glucose into the cells, because now the cells are blocking glucose from coming in. The systems, the communication between insulin and the receptors for insulin aren't working. That's type 2 diabetes, which can be corrected through keto. This is why a teaspoon of glucose is so important, because in the wild, we didn't have accessibility to farm foods. We couldn't even have broccoli every day or kale salads or smoothies like we're having now, because that's not normal in nature. And that is why it's so important to make sure that your carbohydrates are under 20 net carbs a day. I'm going to talk about that in another video, explaining net carbs as opposed to the total number. So I wanted to explain to you guys, this is how much your body can handle blood sugar every time you eat. That's it. Because I always say, if your blood sugar's high, your insulin's high. When your insulin's high, you store fat because you can't poop or pee out that glucose fast enough as it's trying to digest. You've got a 2-3 hour max window, which is why you test your blood sugar 2 to 3 hours after you eat, to make sure that your blood sugar is dropping back down to a safe level, because it will damage cells through glycation. Peace.